Good evening and welcome to St. Joachim. A very warm welcome to those of you who are attending with us in person and those of you who are watching at home. Welcome to Bishop Cotta, who will be our celebrant for this joyful celebration. A worship aid is provided to invite you to participate fully in the liturgy.
Buenas noches y bienvenidos a la Iglesia San Joaquín. Una cálida bienvenida a aquellos que ustedes que asisten en persona y aquellos que están viéndolo en casa. Bienvenido a nuestro obispo Cotta, que será el celebrante de esta alegre celebración. Se proporcionará una ayuda de adoración para invitarlos a participar plenamente en la liturgia, que es el librito que les dieron.
Please remain standing after the proclamation of the gospel until the bishop has blessed the assembly with the book of the Gospels. Also, please remain standing after the great amen until the last person has received the Holy Eucharist.
Por favor, permanezcan de pie después de la proclamación del Evangelio hasta que el obispo haya bendecido la asamblea con el libro de los Evangelios. Además, por favor, permanezcan de pie después de los grandes amén hasta que la última persona haya recibido la Santa Eucaristía.
Confirmation is a solemn rite. No one is to use the flash photography or move throughout the church to get pictures during the Mass. I will be taking your child picture as they're being confirmed. Thank you for your respect for this solemn event.
La confirmación es un rito solemne. Nadie debe usar las fotografías o el flash o moverse a través de la iglesia para obtener fotos durante la misa. Ella tomará foto a su hijo cuando esté siendo confirmada. También, por favor, gracias por su respeto en este solemne acontecimiento. Muchas gracias.
At the conclusion of Mass, the confirmandi will gather on the altar for a picture with Bishop Cotta. Please remain in your seats until after I get the group photo, and then you are welcome to take pictures.
Al terminar la misa, los confirmados se reunirán en el altar acá, enfrente, para tomar la foto con el obispo Cotta. Por favor, permanezcan en sus asientos hasta después de tomar la foto del grupo. Entonces, ustedes serán bienvenidos para que tomen fotografías.
We invite you now to take a moment of silence as we prepare ourselves to celebrate these sacred mysteries.
Los invitamos a guardar un minuto de silencio mientras nos preparamos para celebrar estos misterios sagrados.
Please stand.
I will come to you in the silence. I will lift you from all your fears. You will hear my voice. I claim you as my choice. Be still. Shadows of the night, I will be your light, come and rest in me. Do not be afraid, I am with you. I have called you each by name. Come and follow me, I will bring you.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Peace be with you.
And with your spirit.
Good evening, everyone. Buenas tardes, todos. Bienvenidos a nuestra celebración del sacramento de confirmación. Un sacramento muy importante por los jóvenes, no solamente por los jóvenes, sino por toda la iglesia, porque en este sacramento ellos reciben el Espíritu Santo, el poder, la fuerza, el amor que es Dios. This evening, it's a great pleasure to be here in Lockford, here at St. Joachim's. You know, last year was like, I didn't have an opportunity for confirmations with the pandemic. And this year, it's getting back in the swing of it all. And so it's been wonderful visiting the parishes, touching base with the parishes, and especially being present here for our young people and their families. So it's truly a pleasure. As we gather together this evening, it's still the Easter season, so we give praise and glory to God for the risen Jesus in our life. So we turn toward our Lord, asking pardon of all our sins. I confess to Almighty God, and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and what I have failed to do. To my fault, to my most grievous fault. Therefore I ask Blessed Mary, ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. We pray, Almighty and merciful God, that the Holy Spirit coming near and dwelling graciously within us may make of us a perfect temple of his glory. To our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
Amen. A reading from the Acts of the Apostles. From Paphos, Paul and his companions set sail and arrived at Perga in Pamphylia. But John left them and returned to Jerusalem. They continued on from Perga and reached Antioch in Pisidia. On the Sabbath, they entered into the synagogue and took their seats. After the readings of the law and the prophets, the synagogue officials sent word to them, "My brothers, if one of you has a word of exhortation for the people, please speak." So Paul got up, motioned with his hand, and said, "Fellow children of Israel, and you others who are God-fearing, listen. The God of this people Israel chose our ancestors and exalted the people during their sojourn in the land of Egypt. With uplifted arm, he led them out. And for about 40 years, he put up with them in the desert. When he had destroyed seven nations in the land of Canaan, he gave them their land as an inheritance. At the end of about 450 years. After these things, he provided judges up to Samuel the prophet. Then they asked for a king. God gave them Saul, son of Kish, a man from the tribe of Benjamin, for 40 years. Then he removed him and raised up David as their king. Of him he testified, 'I have found David, son of Jesse, a man after my own heart. He will carry out my every wish.' From this man's descendants, God, according to his promise, he brought to Israel a savior, Jesus. John heralded his coming by proclaiming a baptism of repentance to all the people of Israel. And as John was completing his course, he would say, 'What do you suppose that I am? I am not he. Behold, one is coming after me. I am not worthy to unfasten the sandals of his feet.' The word of the Lord.
Your throne for all generations.
joyful shout. In the light of your countenance, O Lord, they walk. At your name they rejoice all the day, and through your justice they are exalted. Forever with him stands firm. Forever I will sing the goodness of the Lord.
with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John.
Glory to you, O Lord.
When Jesus had washed his disciples' feet, he said to them, "Amen, amen, I say to you, no slave is greater than his master, nor any messenger greater than the one who sent him. If you understand this, blessed are you, and you do it. I am not speaking of all of you. I know those whom I have chosen, but so that the scriptures might be fulfilled, the one who ate my food has raised his heel against me. From now on, I am telling you before all this happens, so that when it does happen, you may believe that I am. Amen, amen, I say to you, whoever receives the one I send receives me, and whoever receives me receives the one who sent me." The Gospel of the Lord. Please remain standing.
First of all, Bishop Cotta, we'd like to welcome you here at St. Joachim's today. It's always an honor to have you here, and we're happy to, that you could be with us and celebrate this confirmation.
Father Sam, thank you very much.
Bishop Cotta, after consulting with those who are in charge of these confirmatis training, I certify that they are well trained. Confirmati, please stand.
Sam. Please be seated. Once again, good evening, everyone. Buenas tardes, otra vez. Buenas tardes. It's truly, again, a pleasure to be here and to officiate, to confer the sacrament of confirmation upon you, the young people of this parish, this community. You know, the outpouring of the Spirit is such a powerful gift that God the Father and our Lord Jesus has given to the church, given to humanity, for us to embrace and to utilize in our lives. Because I'll tell you, without the Holy Spirit, you cannot be a faithful follower of Jesus. You cannot be a good Catholic without the Holy Spirit. You cannot live the Christian walk and live the faith without the help of the Holy Spirit. We try to do it on our own strength, on our own abilities, on our own capacity, and we're not going to make that. We're going to fail. We're going to get frustrated. Some people might even walk away. Just like a few weeks ago, or was it last week in the gospel, how some of the disciples walked away from Jesus because what he was teaching was too much for them. They couldn't take it because it sounded like he's talking kind of crazy here. So it says in the gospel, it said, that day, many turned their backs on him and left his company. And you know what's interesting? Jesus didn't go running after them. He spoke the truth. Holy Spirit, they're attentive. It would touch a person's heart. They would be moved. They say, this man is from God. This man has something to teach us, to share with us. And what he was sharing at that time, where people turned their back, was when Jesus was saying, unless you eat the flesh of the Son of Man, and drink his blood, you have no life in you. So the poor people saying, what's this man trying to say, this Jesus from Nazareth? Eat his flesh, drink his blood. And that's when they said, boy, this is too much for us. They said, this is crazy. Well, like many of us, sometimes we have to hang in there a little longer to get the clear message. To understand exactly what the Lord is prompting us to, leading us to, trying to get us to understand. It takes time to be in the company of the Master in order to understand. And then as things unfolded, realized he was talking about the Eucharist, that he consecrated this bread and wine, saying at the Last Supper, this is me for you. Remember me. This is my body. This is my blood. Oh, that's what he was talking about. So I think it's a lesson learned. We have to hang in there. Sometimes we don't get it right away. Don't turn your back. Don't throw up your hands saying, what is this all about? This is just too much. You know, to be a Catholic, it's just too hard. There's too many things I have to do. And no, hang in there. Because God will surprise you along the way. And that's what the Holy Spirit is. I've been telling the young people, the Holy Spirit is a God of surprises. Just when you think you can't do something, or just wondering, how am I going to figure this out, or what's going to happen here in this situation in my life, God surprises us. And sometimes we get an answer where we never expected to get an answer, or guidance where we never thought we would get guidance, or maybe it's the Holy Spirit working through another person that then helps us. The key for all of you being confirmed today is be open to the Holy Spirit. That's my prayer for you. Because I'll tell you, as bishop, I need young people who have a relationship with the Holy Spirit, or this doesn't make any sense. The Holy Spirit is to empower you to be faithful followers of Jesus. Because as I said earlier, without the Holy Spirit, it's going to be pretty tough. And God the Father knew that, and God the Son, our Lord Jesus, knew that. And he says, we're going to send them a helper. That's the Holy Spirit. Very simple. Who is the Holy Spirit for you? He's your helper. God, who is your helper, call on him. Ask him to help you. I'm sure in the 2 years preparation, you went through all the fruits of the Spirit, all the gifts of the Spirit. Those are for you, for the taking, for the asking. So when you need to be a little more compassionate or patient or understanding or loving or hopeful, or I need more strength in my life, then call upon the Holy Spirit. You know, take him to task. Because, Holy Spirit, you promised you would help me. So I trust that you're going to get me through this. You're going to change my heart where it needs to be changed. Or you're going to give me patience where I need it. Or you're going to make me a little more understanding toward others. Because I had that run-in with that person. And, you know, I don't feel good about it. So help me to be reconciled with that person. That's all the work of the Holy Spirit. I think that's a pretty good deal.
Hermanos, el Espíritu Santo va a dar la capacidad para estos jóvenes para ser discípulos de Cristo. Porque sin el Espíritu Santo, ellos no pueden. Yo no puedo. El poder, la fuerza, el amor, que es Dios, dar la capacidad, gracia, misericordia, los frutos del Espíritu Santo, los dones del Espíritu Santo, todo esto. Y ellos van a recibir una manera muy especial, una forma muy especial, el Espíritu Santo.
Because you already have received the Spirit in baptism. You were baptized in the name of the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit. So, Bishop, then what are we doing here? Because this sacrament confirms what happens at baptism. And now the outpouring of the Spirit is here for you. The key is su corazón, your heart, necesita estar abierta, abierto. That's the key. Your heart needs to be open to what happens to you here tonight. Well, Bishop, you know, am I going to feel different? You might, and maybe you won't. But you're going to know when the Holy Spirit is present to you. You're going to just sense it. You're going to know it. And you're going to, I don't know, it's something, it's hard to explain. But you have to be open, you guys. So again, my prayer for you, your minds are open tonight. Your hearts are open today. Have an ongoing relationship every day with the Holy Spirit. Holy Spirit, what do you ask of me today? As you begin your day, as you end your day, you have to have heart to heart with the Holy Spirit. Or let me tell you, this doesn't make any sense. We're just kind of going through motions. The motions are to lead us to a greater reality is what happens. Like tonight, renewing your baptismal promises. You being anointed with holy chrism, the oil. You responding to the questions I will ask you. Through words and actions, signs and symbols, the visible God becomes present in these tangible ways for us. In the sacraments, the outward sign, as the church calls the sacraments, to bring the reality of this God into our lives. It's beautiful. It's wonderful. I'm just glad I'm here to do this for you. Those to be confirmed, I ask you now to please stand. We're going to have la renovación de los promesas bautismales. Ellos van a dar su respuesta a estas preguntas. En el pasado, como bebés, con niños, ellos... Los papás y los padrinos dieron su respuesta, el día del bautismo. Mas hoy, esta tarde, ellos van a dar, ellos van a ser testigos con su respuesta. Entonces, hermanos, papás, silencio. Padrinos, por favor, silencio. Yo necesito oír la voz de ellos con una voz alta. Tonight these questions aren't for the parents or godparents to answer. You had your opportunity at their baptism. Today, they stand on their own 2 feet, and before me, the bishop, and all of you witnessing what's happening here tonight, this evening, they now profess what they believe. It's a big moment here, because this isn't lighthearted stuff. This is fundamental stuff that gets you through life, because as you know, and from our past year, life can knock us around pretty good and bring all kinds of craziness into our lives. That's why we have to be focused that God is in control of all things. We might have to go through hardship. We might have to go through heartache. We might even have to experience a loss of a loved one. But Lord God, you know what's going on. You're going to help us. That's hanging in there. That's con la capacidad, the capacity to be followers, being faithful. So I'm going to ask you these questions. I need to hear your answer loud and clear, okay, with a good hearty I do, okay? First question is really important because it's everything that's against God. Anti-Christ, anti-God, anti-love, anti-church, anti-hope. It's all about hatred, violence, destruction, death, evil. I'm going to ask you this question. I need to hear your answer. Do you renounce Satan and all his works and all his empty promises? Do you believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth? Do you believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, suffered death and was buried, rose again from the dead, and is seated at the right hand of the Father? Do you believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who today, through the sacrament of confirmation, is given to you in a special way, just as he was given to the apostles on the day of Pentecost? Do you believe in the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and life everlasting? Well, friends, this is our faith. This is the faith of the church, and we are proud to profess it in Christ Jesus our Lord. Amen. Now have the laying on of hands with really small groups. The bishop could lay hands individually on the confirmandi, but again, tonight we're going to do it as a group. So I invite Father Sam here at my side to also call down the Holy Spirit upon you in this gesture of laying on of hands. It's a very ancient gesture from the Bible, calling down, anointing the person, God's Spirit coming down to the individual. So this prayer is a powerful prayer. I ask you to bow your heads in reverence to the outpouring of the Spirit upon you now. Nosotros tenemos la imposición de las manos. Dearly beloved, let us pray to God the Almighty Father for these his adopted sons and daughters, already born again to eternal life in baptism, that he will graciously pour out the Holy Spirit upon them, to confirm them with his abundant gifts, and through his anointing, conform them more fully to Christ, the Son of God. We now acknowledge a few moments of silence here in the church as we acknowledge the presence of the Holy Spirit with us here. Almighty God, Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, who brought these your servants to new birth by water and the Holy Spirit, freeing them from sin, send upon them, O Lord, the Holy Spirit, the Paraclete. Give them the spirit of wisdom and understanding, the spirit of counsel and fortitude, the spirit of knowledge and piety. Fill them with the spirit of the fear of the Lord, through Christ our Lord. Amen. Just a few moments, you will come forward with your sponsors. They will present you to me by name. And I will say, as I get the Holy Chrism, I will make the sign of the cross in your forehead, and I will say, be sealed with the gift of the Holy Spirit. And your response is, and then I will offer you the greeting of Jesus, the Easter greeting of Jesus. Peace be with you. I think we're ready. I think you guys are ready. have you be sealed with the gift of the Holy Spirit. Janelle, be sealed with the gift of the Holy Spirit. Victor, be sealed with a gift. With the gift of the Holy Spirit. Be sealed with the gift of the Holy Spirit. With the gift of the Holy Spirit. Teresa, be sealed with the gift of the Holy Spirit. And be sealed with a gift. And be sealed with the gift of the Holy Spirit. Mm-hmm.
with the gift of the Holy Spirit. And be sealed with the gift of the Holy Spirit. I invite those who have just been confirmed to please stand. God bless you. Congratulations. I invite all of us to stand as we continue our prayer. My dear friends, let us be one in prayer to God our Father, as we are one in the faith, hope, and love His Spirit gives.
For the Holy Church of God, in union with Francis, our Pope, Myron, our Bishop, Sam, our Pastor, that God, who gathers us together by the Holy Spirit, may help us grow in unity of faith and love until His Son returns in glory, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all men and women of every race and nation, that they may acknowledge the one God as Father, and in the bond of common fellowship seek His kingdom, which is peace and joy in the Holy Spirit, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all who are sometimes forgotten, especially for the poor, the sick, and the aged, that God might change our hearts and move us to love them in the image of Christ, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For these sons and daughters of God, confirmed by the gift of the Holy Spirit, that they give witness to Christ by lives built on faith and love, let us pray to the Lord. For their parents, godparents, Joanna, and all the catechists who led them in faith, that by word and example they may always encourage them to follow the way of Jesus Christ, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord,
hear our prayer. For vocations to the priesthood and the consecrated life, that young people Christ is calling will hear his voice with courage and generosity, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord,
hear our prayer.
O God, who gave the Holy Spirit to your apostles, and will that through them and their successors, the same Spirit be handed on to the rest of the faithful, listen favorably to our prayer, and grant that your divine grace, which was at work when the gospel was first proclaimed, may now spread through the hearts of those who believe in you. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Pray, my brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. Receive in your mercy, O Lord, the prayers of your servants, and grant that being conformed more perfectly to your Son, they may grow steadily in bearing witness to him, as they share in the memorial of his redemption, by which he gained for us your Holy Spirit. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you. And with
your spirit.
Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. ascending above all the heavens and sitting at your right hand, he poured out the promised Holy Spirit on your adopted children. Therefore, now and for ages unending, and with all the hosts of angels, we sing to you with all our hearts, crying out as we acclaim.
Holy, holy, holy.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, and all you have created rightly gives you praise. For through your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, by the power and working of the Holy Spirit, you give life to all things and make them holy. And you never cease to gather a people to yourself, so that from the rising of the sun to its setting, a pure sacrifice may be offered to your name. Therefore, O Lord, we humbly implore you, by the same Spirit, graciously make holy these gifts we have brought to you for consecration, that they may become the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate these mysteries. For on the night he was betrayed, he himself took bread, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it. For this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
When we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim your death, O Lord, until you come again.
Therefore, Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the saving passion of your Son, his wondrous resurrection and ascension into heaven, and as we look forward to a second coming, we offer you in thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice. Look, we pray, upon the oblation of your church, and recognizing the sacrificial victim by whose death you willed to reconcile us to yourself, grant that we who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son and filled with his Holy Spirit, may become one body, one spirit in Christ.
May he make of us an eternal offering to you, so that we may obtain an inheritance with your elect, especially with the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with the blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and the glorious martyrs, with Saint Joachim, and with all the saints on whose constant intercession we rely for unfailing God.
Te pedimos, Padre, que esta víctima
de reconciliación, traiga la paz y la salvación al mundo entero. Confirme la fe en la caridad a tu iglesia peregrina en la tierra y tu siervo, el Papa Francisco, mi su siervo indigno y orden episcopal a los presbíteros, diáconos y a todo el pueblo redimido por ti. Atiende los deseos y súplicas de esta familia que has congregado en la presencia. Reúne en torno a ti, Padre misericordioso, a todos tus hijos dispersos por el mundo, a nuestros hermanos defuntos y a cuantos murieron en tu amistad, recíbalos en tu reino, donde esperamos gozar todos juntos de la plenitud eterna de tu gloria. Por Cristo, Señor nuestro, por quien concedes al mundo todos los bienes. Por Cristo, con Él y en Él, a ti, Dios Padre omnipotente, y en la unidad del Espíritu Santo, todo honor y toda gloria, por los siglos de los siglos.
Amén, amén, amén.
At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father,
who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope in the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will. Who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord,
amen.
Thank you.
of the Lord, united in one spirit, ignited by the fire, still burning through the ages, still present in our lives. Oh, Comforter, to of life and fire of love, the souls anointing from above. We are a pilgrim people, we are the Church of God, a family of disciples of the Lord, united in one spirit, ignited by the fire, still burning through the ages, still present in our lives.
Let us pray. Accompany with your blessing from this day forward, O Lord, those who have been anointed with the Holy Spirit and nourished by the sacrament of your Son, so that with all trials overcome, they may gladden your church by their holiness and through their works and their charity, foster her growth in the world, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
For our final blessing, many of you maybe through your sponsors or maybe your family received gifts as a remembrance of your confirmation. I will bless those religious articles at this time if you so have them. Might be a necklace, a cross, a medal, a Bible, a rosary. I will do that now. Just to hold the gifts up for the blessing. So if you want to just hold the gifts up. I bless these religious articles that were given to you on this day of your confirmation, that they be a reminder of the outpouring of the Spirit in your life, they be a reminder of you, the closeness of God to you, living in you and through you. And may Almighty God bless these religious articles, these gifts, in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Go in peace to love and serve the Lord.
The Lord be with you.
Bow your heads and pray for God's blessing.
Your response is amen after these words of blessing. May God the Father Almighty bless you, whom He has given, who He has made your adopted sons and daughters, reborn from water and the Holy Spirit. And may He keep you worthy of His fatherly love.
Amen.
May His only begotten Son, who promised that the Spirit of truth would abide in His church, bless you and confirm you by His power in the confession of the true faith.
Amen.
May the Holy Spirit, who kindles the fire of charity in the hearts of disciples, bless you and lead you blameless and gathered as one into the joy of the kingdom of God.
Amen. Amen.
May Almighty God bless all who are gathered here, the Father, Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Now go in the peace of Christ to love and serve the Lord.
Thanks be to God. Congratulations. God bless you.
Blessed are the poor in spirit, longing for the Lord. For God's coming kingdom shall be theirs. Blessed are the sorrowing, for they shall be consoled. And the meek shall come to rule the are there.